So welcome to DSI TV, Gunnar and Marika. We're very excited to have you here today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I wanted to start with if you could tell us a little bit about your win at the British Nationals, because you won the Professional Latin this year.
We did indeed.
But it was quite an exciting year for you because, well, tell us, why was it special?
It was very special because we were sort of last minute with everything. Because my naturalization came in literally the day before the competition. So it was very stressful for us.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously we were still ready for the competition, but we had no idea when the document was going to come in. So
whether we were going to be able to dance or not.
Yeah.
So, and even when to go to Blackpool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So for people who don't know, one of the couple has to have a British passport.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you need to be naturalized as a British citizen, mm-hmm. Or have a passport. And obviously the whole process is quite long.
Mm-hmm.
You should be here for 7 years, I believe it is,
mm-hmm.
before you can get your naturalization.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been here now since 2009, right?
Mm-hmm.
And obviously we started the process, but we didn't really think that we were going to dance until the day before we got the phone call, document comes in, we can dance.
Ready to go, but you just needed the passport.
That's right.
How does
Absolutely.
It work? Do you have to show someone,
yes.
kind of on the day you have to take it with you?
Literally,
yes.
on the day,
yeah.
we picked up the document obviously the day before, drove to Blackpool, and then we had to show it to Brian Allen to get confirmation that we could dance.
Yeah.
And yeah, so it was really on the morning of the competition that we found out we would be able to dance.
It's
so
amazing.
Mm.
Was it a very
yeah.
excited journey to Blackpool then?
Yes.
It was stressful, actually.
It was quite stressful because at that time it was still, are we going to dance or not?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was still not 100% confirmed.
Yeah.
So it really was only on the Friday morning where we had the confirmation.
Yeah.
And we had to dance in the evening.
Yeah.
So,
how
yeah.
exciting. So tell me how it felt to win after all of that.
It was amazing.
Yeah.
It was truly amazing to stand on that floor and just, well, have the trophy in your hand. And it was actually kind of surreal, like, because all of the stress before, like
mm-hmm.
thinking, are we going to dance, are we not?
Yeah, we really didn't think it was going to happen. Like, as close as we were getting to the time we were supposed to dance, like in terms of the days, we
mm-hmm.
were like, okay, this is not going to happen.
Yeah.
It's really too little amount of time.
Yeah.
But at the end, we made it. So that was really nice to step into that floor and say, okay,
yeah.
now we can dance it.
And
yeah.
did you enjoy the dancing on the night?
Yeah.
Very
yeah.
much, very much.
Much.
Just
must have felt like a celebration.
Just
exactly.
totally.
Completely.
Yeah, just totally free and, yeah, just went for it. So Winter Gardens actually looked a little bit different this year with all the...
Looked a little bit smaller.
The scaffolding and
yeah.
everything
yeah.
happening now.
But at the time, it didn't matter.
It didn't
yeah.
matter, no.
No.
You'd look up to the ceiling and it was like metal rods in the air instead of chandeliers. But it was still nice.
Still
it was still Blackpool.
Still yeah.
Exactly. And it
yeah.
was still that competition.
Yeah.
And having the trophy in your hand was just amazing.
No,
so
it's an incredible result.
Absolutely. So,
tell us a little bit about your partnership. Where are you based?
We're based in London,
mm-hmm.
in Cheam, actually.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is our basically, well, where we live, where we practice, where we teach.
Yes.
Everything happens there.
And we live just above the studio, so go up,
no.
go down.
That's a perfect place.
It's very convenient,
yeah.
Yes.
Okay, one of my questions was going to be, what are the advantages of living where you live? But
well, there you go.
Yes,
and you're
travel
you're teaching
course.
There as well.
Yes.
Yeah.
Investing
so
there, I imagine.
Most of our time in there.
Yeah.
Yes, everything happens in that little village. So,
so how long have you danced together?
The
six
end
years.
Of March this year is going to be 6 years.
Oh gosh, that's a decent amount of time.
Yes.
And I'm always interested to hear from dancers what their tryout was like. Did
Ooh.
You know from the moment you danced together that it was something that was going to work, or was it something?
For me, it was very clear. As soon as we did a little bit of rumba choreography together,
mm-hmm.
in Chin, obviously, and for me it was like straight on. Yes, this is gonna work. I can work with her. It feels great.
Well,
so
was
yeah.
it the same for you?
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
It was really nice straight away. I think there was no question. So
yeah.
Yeah.
And did that tend to be the case with tryouts, or have there been times before where you've had to work at things, or is it more of a instinctive sort of?
I think in
thing?
The past, I mean, you always kind of feel it if it's gonna work or not.
Yeah.
Mm,
yes. For me, in the past, it's also been quite clear whether it's the right decision to make or not.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think it's pretty clear.
I think you
don't
know
what your experience
you
is.
You know, yes, when you have the tryout, how do you feel about it? How do you feel about that person?
Mm-hmm.
You know, are you gonna get on?
Yeah.
Other than just in the dancing, you know, because you still spend a lot of time together. So.
Yeah.
So.
Of course, that's part
of personalities
it.
Personalities
not just dancing,
to,
is it? It
yeah.
Has to, yeah. Mm-hmm. Get on as well.
Yeah.
I was going to ask about what you thought made your partnership work.